Hey everyone, welcome to another installment of Harry Potter Theory. In today's video, we're going to be discussing the Dursleys, Vernon, Petunia, and Dudley. More specifically, we're going to be addressing their perceptions of magic, and why their hatred of all things magical may actually be somewhat justified. Let's start right at the beginning with Harry's adoption. When Harry's parents were on October 31st, 1981, the decision was made would be raised by his aunt Petunia and her family. This decision was made on the basis that Harry would be protected by the blood of Lily's sister Petunia, so long as he called her home his own. Right from the get-go, the Dursleys were massively critical of Harry, largely because they associated him with the world of magic that they so loathed. They didn't like anything that was out of the ordinary, and all of a sudden when Petunia was faced with raising her magical young nephew. They never told Harry about how his parents died, never told him about Hogwarts, and they failed to even mention the magical world to him. They hid Harry's past from him because it pertained to a world they hated, a world they wanted to pretend didn't exist. Don't get me wrong, the Dursleys hated magic in part due to their personalities, which certainly can't be justified, but in this video, I want to explore
to be American public be told the truth.
After the embassy was attacked in Benghazi, a lot of people questioned what the White House knew and when they knew it.
Some claim that the terrorist attack was covered up by the Obama administration. Now, why would the Obama administration want to cover this up? This attack occurred right before a presidential election. The last thing the Obama administration would want would be embarrassing information coming out on the eve of the election.
They blame a YouTube video for sparking the attack, but Al-Qaeda terrorists took responsibility for it.
Security. People said we need more security. They didn't get it.
Could the murders have been prevented? And why was President Obama reluctant to blame Al-Qaeda?
The U.S. consulate had asked for multiple rounds of security, was denied it.
My favorite basketball team is the Lakers. There we go. She asked, what? Okay. My favorite basketball team has always been, since I was a kid, the Los Angeles Lakers. Mostly, may you rest in peace, Kobe Bryant. It's because I've always looked up to Kobe Bryant. The time I was 8 years old, ever since I first started watching the Lakers on TV. Like for many years, I've always looked up to him for all his hard work and dedication, his time to put into practicing, his motivation to win every single game. Goodness.
Everybody has to have their own in their room. That
sounds
like
it. I know. I didn't
have to do with this.
Burn, Joe.
It's gonna burn you, Joe.
Hi. Real quick check-in. You're a comedian? Nice. Oh, it's because it's kind of dark in here. I'm sorry. It's just doing a little live stream before I go to sleep. Sorry how dark it is. I just kind of don't want to get back up to turn on the light and get up again to turn it off. And got one of those. It's because it, I guess. It's because I don't want to get back up just to turn off the light and don't have any of those clap-on lights. Like I saw. It's cold? No, it's actually pretty. It feels good in here. I'm in my room. Wait, what? Yeah. Is it cold where you're? Oh, okay. Remember those clap-on, clap-off commercials back in the 2000s? Thought that was the coolest thing ever. Remember seeing those as a kid, I'm like, what? Oh. Yeah, me too. Makes it easier because sometimes I forget to turn off my light before I get into bed. Okay. Hope you join in my next live stream. Hope to see you next time. Okay. If you have time, I understand if you're busy. Yeah.